Hello, Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com with a look at a LEGO City set from 2012. This one's just called Fire Plane. It came with 522 pieces. Since the set is called Fire Plane, I figure I should focus on the Fire Plane itself. Nice large size, very streamlined in the front with the use of that single canopy piece, which has been used on a number of different types of aircraft. You got the twin propeller engines, nice big T-tail back here, very large stabilizer surface. Interestingly enough, they used stickers on the aileron sections, or the flap sections really, just bringing in an extra little bit of detail there. The build is pretty straightforward. I mean, there are a lot of pieces to this thing for younger kids to put together, but all the construction techniques are pretty basic, and it's really designed to be easy to put together. You know, just takes some time. Has a nice color scheme going for it. A nice balance, I would say, you know, keeping it from being just all red or something. It sits very low to the ground, and it has no landing gear because it's intended to be a seaplane. It lands in water, so it's got the little pontoons out on the ends that act to stabilize it, and most of the weight of the thing would just be supported by the fuselage, which also doubles as a hull. And you can see it's got the extensions on the sides, which are supposed to represent extra thick provisions for water tanks inside, or at least one large water tank, which would be filled up by coming down to the water, scooping up a bunch of water from below, from a lake surface or something like that, and then taking that to wherever the fire is to dump it off. On the underside, they actually have a little scoop device which you can open up, but I'm not going to open it up right now because it's not really intended in this toy to be used for scooping. It's intended to be used for dropping, and it has a real tank in there that is full of 1x1 cylinders. We'll see that from the top. This is a cool use of this open wheel race car nose piece to give you a little bit of a handle to open this up, and that's the tank, and it's just completely filled with all of these pieces that are intended to represent water. So this is where us as humans would, as huge figs, would fill the thing up, and then that gives you the ability to then go off and drop them remotely. While we're looking at this thing from the top, let me take the canopy off, and there's your pilot seat right there with a couple of control sticks. Got a full, nice looking, four wide console using two printed slope pieces. This looks really good inside of here. And behind that seat, there's a second seat for your bomber, for the person who's gonna be probably doing navigation, communication, and actually controlling the release of the water, or if you've got fire retardant, that would be put in there, and that's what this person back here would be taken care of. And you got a couple of printed pieces showing pressures and probably altitude and other stuff. You got valves that can control and other stuff like that. Interestingly, it's hard to see, but through the rear windows, you can see some tanks in there. And that's an interesting detail that they put in there. Again, you can just barely see it from the outside, and they don't make it easy for you to access those. So they're really not intended to be looked at other than through these windows again. But you can see a valve there on the side, another one over here on this side as well. As far as I can guess, those are representing chemical fire retardant tanks. A ground vehicle setup is also included with this set, and that's a Jeep. I mean, it's not a licensed Jeep. They can't call it a Jeep, but that is clearly a Jeep. And that is awesome, because Jeeps are pretty awesome. There are a ton of Jeep fanatics out there who I'm sure appreciated this model. It is, again, it's targeted towards kids. It's not a super complex build, but it's something that we haven't seen very much, especially in the modern era of LEGO. And it's a good looking thing. The only thing that I don't like about it is that it's a six wide build, and yet it only has one single seat. The driver would sit right there in that yellow seat in the middle of the thing. Otherwise, I very much like the design of the vehicle. A little storage compartment back in the back, and then it pulls this trailer along, which can be unhitched. It just has a little ball hitch there, but this is some sort of pumping unit, and it's got a hose here that can be taken off. This can be connected to your plane. Remember just a minute ago we saw those valves on the side near the tanks towards the rear. I believe this is for refilling the chemical tanks. Now, they did put a blue transparent little one by one piece there at the end, which suggests water, and I'm sure that plenty of kids would just use this as a thing, you know, get water from the plane, even though the plane lands in water, you know, and then take this out to fight fires from the ground. Actually use this as a nozzle to try to wet down areas, probably a wide spray area or something like that. It's important to be able to use your imagination, so folks who are really experienced with firefighting will be able to give scientific answers to all of these things, but you have to remember this is a toy, this is for kids, and they're going to be using it in various different ways, and I think it's important to acknowledge that. This is really nice. Chainsaw. I like that design. They've used it a bunch of times. It works, fits in the hands of minifigs. It's a good thing. Speaking of minifigs, here they are now. Three in total, pilot, co-pilot, whichever can be whichever you choose, and then one guy on the ground who would be driving the Jeep around, the Jeep that's not actually a Jeep. I like that they've given the guy on the right the extra high visibility uniform, because that's really important for a guy who's going to be on the ground during aerial warfare against a fire, so that makes him more visible, I think, especially to the aircraft if he's going to be targeting or doing any operations down on the ground while they are operating up above as well. And speaking of targeting, there's a target for you. A stand of trees. You get two trees that are very nicely built up. Lots of parts used here. The two different colors of foliage with the regular green and the bright green. Just a lot of bulk, you know, a lot of mass to the trees. These are especially nice for the city series. Most of the ones they do are smaller and simpler. These are really proper. They even have little buttresses down towards the roots there that make them look more sturdy. And you get all these flame pieces, and you can distribute the flame pieces between the two if you like, if you want to make it look like a larger forest fire, or you can make it look like you're trying to stop the fire, so you've already put out the fire on this one, and then you can take the flame pieces off of this one when it's, you know, when it's all put out. And the last thing that I want to show is what a bombing run would really look like, so you can see exactly how the simulated water pieces come out of the plane. So, you know, make a nice low run, and as you pass, you're just going to pull up on the little lever right here. You can do it with one hand, or you can do it with two hands. It's going to make quite a mess, but it makes quite a show as you drop all those pieces out. Yeah, just like that. So pretty nice set, a good looking, easy to handle airplane, very nice looking little land vehicle, nice little trailer. Only a few pretty basic minifigs. I could have done for more minifigs in a set of this size, but there's enough to use all the stuff in the set. And the trees are really cool too. Let me know what you think about this set, whether you like it or you dislike it, or if there are some specific components that you like better than others. It'll be good to hear what your thoughts are. I'm going to go build some more stuff so I can bring you some more videos. Thank you for watching this one, and I'll be talking to you again soon.